This blank is an information function that is useful to check if a value is blank. It accepts only one parameter that is checked for being strictly equal to blank. Let's first see some example of its usage. I am calling isBlank passing different arguments. First, a blank value which is equal to blank, and you see that the result is true. If you pass to it a numeric value like 42, isBlank is false because 42 is not false. And the same is valid also for empty values like 0 or an empty string. Despite being empty, both 0 and an empty string, they are not blank. Indeed, isBlank of 0 and isBlank of an empty string return false. Beware, this is different than the equality operator in DAX, because if you check for an empty string to be equal to blank, the result will be true. And if you check for the empty string to be strictly equal to blank, the result will be false, because an empty string is equal to blank, but it is not strictly equal to blank. You can also use blank passing to it tables, but the result is most likely wrong or produces an error. Therefore, we strongly suggest you not to use isBlank to check whether a table is empty or not. There is the isEmpty function that has this purpose. Let's see some examples. I have created a table empty set that filters a table containing only one value with false as a condition. Therefore, empty set returns an empty table. And if you check isBlank empty set, the result is true. So it is likely that isBlank is checking whether the table is empty or not. But this is not what is actually happening. If you create a table set with blank that contains only one row containing blank, the result is true. Now, this table actually contains a value. It contains one row with a blank inside of it. Let's see what happens if you add further rows. I add another row, which is, again, another blank. So I created a table with two rows, both of which are blank. And if I run it, the result is still true, despite there are two rows. The reason is, the engine performs an automatic conversion of a table to a scalar value if the table contains only one value. And in this case, the table set with blank contains two rows but only one value, which happens to be blank. Therefore, isBlank returns true. If you use a table that contains numbers like 1, 1, it shows only one value, which is not blank. So there are two rows, one value, that value is not blank, and isBlank will return false. You can see that automatic conversion is happening if you use two different values. By using two values, now the automatic conversion of a table to a scalar value cannot happen, and this results in an error. So if you want to check whether a table is empty or not, you can use the isEmpty function. Avoid using isBlank. Let's now see another example where the difference between blanks and empty strings matters. I created a measure empty names that does calculate count rows of customers where the customer name is equal to blank. And then I created another measure blank names that does the same calculation using isBlank. You see the result? There are 67 customers with an empty name that includes both empty strings and blanks. Whereas if you just check for strictly equal to blank, there are only 34 customers whose name is blank. Empty strings are not counted.